Breaks loose.
Yeah, that's right. That's the one that you spill your water in. So that's what you're calling. Yeah, that's right.
It's good. Thanks. Good luck. Mm-hmm. Ladies and gentlemen, honorable judges. My name is Terry.
My name is Grace.
And I'm Christopher.
And we're here today to represent Actor. Sorry, Lucas, it's not Actor. And don't let the name fool you. We're not a new dinosaur species or anything, but we are here to represent an online platform dedicated to helping actors connect to playwrights and for playwrights to connect to producers.
Now, why is there a need for this? There is a huge problem today in that actors can't find jobs because it's super time consuming. Casting calls can take up to 8 hours, and if you don't get cast, you just spent a whole day sitting in the office waiting for people to call you. Secondly, the acting industry is a super fragmented market today. So there are tons of different producers, there are tons of different talent agencies, and to find them to each other is super difficult. Thirdly, there are more non-traditional elements like Vimeo and YouTube that are popping up, and these people don't need agents. Agents take a huge percent of your salary, and these people can just find people on Actor to help them make their production.
So if you're a producer or if you're a playwright, you most likely will be asking yourself, how can I find actors who share my same passion, or how can I find actors who can make my dream a reality for making a film or a play? Well, that's where we come in. We've all heard of Airbnb, LinkedIn, Uber. We're kind of like the same as these companies, except we're focusing more on the arts and entertainment industry. So essentially, we're not just listing them kind of like Craigslist, but we're actually actively connecting the actors, playwrights, and producers. So we're just going to give you a little demo right now about kind of how our website actually works. So when you sign in, you're first going to be prompted to enter some information about yourself. This is going to be entered into our filtering system, which helps the different actors and the other artists find specific criteria for finding the people they want. So we have tabs in actors, writers, and producers, and this is all going to be a part of connecting them and actively managing the people.
So why do we think that there's a market today? If you guys just read that slide, there's a huge market. We can make a lot of money. There's a lot of the television and film industry that contributes to Canada's GDP, and it's growing.
So now you want to know, how are we going to make money? Well, we have three main streams of revenue. The first one is going to be commission. So whenever actors connect with the producer, then the producer will pay a fixed amount of money for that project to continue on. We also have advertising, so this is going to be for the free users. So our service is free when you start. However, if you do realize this is working for you, or if you really enjoy how the whole system works, then you can start paying for a premium model, which will be based on a subscription fee.
And like all businesses, we have risks, but we think we're in a unique position to mitigate them because no one does what we do. So for legal and liability issues, where people say they are someone who they're not, we have user authentication, where they can connect their IMDb accounts to our thing. And for security, there's privacy, so we make sure that these people can maintain their own selves. There's also lots of competition, except there are two main buckets that we have. So the first type is the traditional talent agencies. They have limited resources and it's expensive. For the online platforms, there are all these in white up there, except they don't do the same things we do. They have a listing of people that you can find, but you have to search for them yourself, so they don't actually match you, and they're fragmented. We connect all of the services of our competitors together.
Okay, so some ways that we'll get traction is we won't be targeting the mass the massive whole industry. Instead, we'll be targeting like the small movie or film associations, theater and art schools such as Ryerson and OCAD. And another way that we're going to do it is by word of mouth, which is basically if someone has like a great time on our website, they might say tell 3 friends, then those 3 friends might tell another 3 friends, and this will be the best way because it's it doesn't cost anything for us. And for our action plan, by the end of 2016, we plan on being able to finish and refine our detailed business plan and our product development. So we are looking for $70,000. This $70,000 will go into product development, marketing, and some of it will also go into legal advice. $20,000 will go to product development, $40,000 for marketing, and $10,000 for legal advice.
So out of the many actors and playwrights we did interview, one of them is Jeff Scoville, who is a stuntsman, and he said something very similar to many of what the other actors have said. He agrees that it's very time-consuming to constantly find new gigs, and sometimes he misses out on a lot of opportunities as a result. And this is actually a picture of him on set of 12 Monkeys. So why are we such a great business? What makes us so special? Well, in summary, we are expanding this idea in a growing market. The film industry is something that's going to continue to expand in the near future. We have a very passionate team, so all of us, we have our different expertise, and we're all very interested in the arts. And as well, we are serving an underserved market. So the people, filmmakers or independent actors who want to get their name out and start doing something better than what they're doing right now, that's kind of the target market of what we're trying to serve. And that concludes our presentation. Thank you.
Go back to the competition. Competition's fine. These are established.
Yeah, so essentially these are all actually established companies. So if we look at, take for example, Showfax. That's a company that exists right now. Well, all these exist, but what they do is one segment of what we do as actors. So Showfax, what they actually do is they distribute the scripts to the individual actors, but that's all they do. And essentially what we're trying to do is we're trying to combine what a lot of these companies do and make it into one system that works efficiently.
The talent pro would seem to do what you're doing, I'm assuming matching talent to opportunities. Do they have a similar business model to what you've proposed?
They do, but part of what they're doing is in our, let me do a little signal. So this is Talent Pro, this is us. We kind of engulf Talent Pro. So what Talent Pro does is connect people, like kind of Tinder, but for actors. What we do is do that, and we provide scripts so that we can drive the passion for actors and producers so they know what they're getting into before they do that. So there's, we combine Showfax, Screenplay Online, Sides Express, and all these together with our own algorithm.
And so you're going to pull the clients from those services, probably, right? You're engulfing them. How do you compete? So how do you compare to their pricing structure? Do they take commissions? Do they do advertising? Do you know how much you would get from a commission? Do you have a percentage targeted?
So for that first question, we don't quite know their pricing, but we do know that if consumers were to use their services, they'd have to go from website to website to website. That's kind of annoying, right, guys? So for the finance part.
So for the finance part, out of each commission, we'll be taking $10 like off of each meeting between the people.
I think this is very easily scalable because you're just talking about the Canadian market right now, and to the extent it works, you know, the adoption in other geographic areas is easy. What I'm struggling with now, and if you guys can help me understand, so I've had clients that are talent agencies, and their business model is, you're absolutely right, Grace, it's expensive. But the expensive is is worthwhile to a lot of production companies, whether it be large scale, mid, or small scale, because what the talent agencies do is they alleviate the pain of that matchmaking process, which can be quite horrendous with the number of people who want to be actors and actresses these days, right? And filtering through that. So that's why it's costly. But how does your platform attract, you know, whether it be producers to move away from the talent agencies? Because what I actually know is talent agencies use those competitors you mentioned as a tool for them to find and deliver results for their clients, the producers and the production companies. How do you disrupt that process with your platform?
Okay, so if we take a look. Oh, wait, hold on. Whoa.
Yeah.
That's a good question.
Lucas, I can stay?
They win.
30 seconds left.
Oh. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, just tell us. Yeah.
We provide a platform that connects these people because they know what they want. So agencies, they're kind of a middleman, and we want to eliminate that because it's inefficient. Right. If I am an agent and you're my actor, you tell me what I want, and then I'm like, oh, he wants that. I'm going to find someone who wants that, and they're passionate with each other. If we eliminate the agent, then you can see that they talk to each other instead of me talking to them.
Right, and also that's kind of the idea of the filtering system we're going to use on the website. So it does make it a lot more efficient because you can just type in, let's say I'm looking for someone who's blonde, someone who's 6 foot, who has experience in these fields, and then you will be matched. Kind of like how Amazon does it, where they have recommended products for you once you buy one thing.
Right.
It's a similar idea of where we know what certain people want because of the way they filter their information.
Okay. Good answer.
Are you going to have somebody behind the scenes doing this? So are you actually going to have talent scouts working for you doing the connections, or is it going to be a logarithm on the computer or an algorithm?
It's going to be an algorithm, yes.
Okay, and like you said, you're going to have, like, if you might like this, like Amazon does. Mm-hmm. If I'm looking for something very, very specific and you don't have it, what are you going to do?
Well, that's why the filtering system will be based on very, I guess, broad categories, so it won't be anything super specific. Let's say you can
blonde hair, blue eyes, 6'5".
Right, so this would be the information you enter when you make an account.
Yeah,
so right,
that's what I want. I'm a producer and I want someone that's got that, and you don't have anybody. What are you going to do?
Can I hop in for a second? Okay, say you want something really specific, you search and then it comes up empty. We can suggest places where you can find these people.
So you're going
we
to be sending the clients somewhere else.
Yeah.
Yes, if we don't have them. But as we grow, we hope to engulf these other people so that we can have more people to work with. And this is also like just a very low barrier to entry. So a lot of people are just kind of people that aren't professional actors. So we're going to have a whole range of weird mix. Weird people. That's not nice. Okay, you know what I mean?
Okay, guys, thank you.
Yeah.
To the other teams, consider the bar was just raised.